Welcome to Beginners Week number 7. Can't wait for you to do today's workout. We've got a really cool total body workout ready for you. So remember, get ready, grab your weights, grab your dumbbells, lay your mat out, get really excited for today's workout, and really put as much energy as you can into this one. It's going to be a lot of fun. Jump right in. Let's get ready to go. Keep your core tight,
shift forward onto your tippy toes and really keep that belly button pulled in. Not holding your breath, but holding your core in. We're at the halfway mark, just 15 seconds left. Almost there, keep holding. It's tough. 5 seconds. And stop. Good work. So, we're gonna come up, standing up, no weights on this one. We're gonna do lateral lunges. So, legs are gonna come wide, touch your hands right down. If you can't touch your palms flat, then just touch your fingertips to the floor. We'll reduce your range of motion a little bit if you're still not able to get right down. So we're just doing 8 to each side, making sure that one leg stays completely straight, toes are in a perfect alignment, and facing forward. One more on each side. Good work. All right, let's dig back in. We're gonna jump back on our bench, right into it, with chest lies. So let's take it right up and come right into these. You'll find the second set's gonna feel a little easier. So remember, we've got 10 of these, and we wanna get down as far as we can. Squeeze the hands a little bit as you come up. All right, taking it up. We're gonna go back into that dreadful plank. So right down on your belly, we're gonna start right down. You'll see sometimes I clasp my hands together, kind of just squeeze my hands a little bit. It takes pressure off of thinking about what I'm doing. So let's get ready, curl those toes under. Back in for 30 seconds. Make sure that you shift it forward so that you're not leaned back like this, but you really shift it up. Elbows are directly under your shoulders, and that core is pulled in nice and tight. You might start to feel like you're shaking a little bit. Totally normal. We've just got 11 seconds left. You can do it. Keep holding. In 5. And stop. Whew. Good work. All right, let's come up. We're gonna come back in. 8 to each side on our lateral lunges, so let's dig that right in. Chest stays up nice and high. Really sit that butt back down, getting as low as you can into that hip. So you're really gonna feel this in the inner thigh and the exterior hip. One more on each side, touch them right down. Good work. All right, so grab a quick sip of water, and then we're gonna dig in for set number 3. All right, take your weights up, and let's go. Keep your core, every core is always tight no matter what we're doing. All right. So let's get ready. Come down for that last set of plank. I know this is tough to start with, but start strong, finish weak. It's the only way to get stronger. So right down on your belly, curl those toes under, elbows right under your shoulders, and let's come up right into that plank. Keeping the core tight. So you're pulling the belly in, but as you can hear, I'm still able to talk because I'm not holding my breath. Big difference in holding your breath and pulling your abs in nice and tight. 10 seconds left. Keep holding. In 5, tighten it up and stop. Whew. Good work. You can really feel that everywhere, especially when it's like right at the beginning of your workout. All right, let's come wide right into those lateral lunges. Toes are pointing forward, chest stays up. Get in as deep as you can. You're really gonna feel this in the hip, the glutes. And one more on each side, right down and up. Good work, grab some water. We're gonna get ready to move on to set number two. Single arm row again, and we're going to lean it over so that we're on one side. We're going to do this one from the floor. So we're going to lean right into it. Core is nice and tight. We're going for 10 on each side. Make sure that you give that little bit of a squeeze so that you're about 1 to 2 seconds in. Hesitate and 1 to 2 seconds out. All right, switch it up to the other side. So we're gonna use our leg as our bench and row it in. Chest stays up, abs stay nice and tight throughout the whole move. Nice and slow, squeeze it back, bring it in, and let it out nice and slow. All right, so we're gonna flip over on our back. We're doing scissors this time. Put your hands under your back if you like, if you need to. Keep those legs nice and straight. Crunch it up. And let's take these nice and slow, actually. Make sure that we're really feeling this in the abs. And let's bend the knees. Put them in for just a second. And we're going to come back up. We're going to take our heavy weights again today, and we're gonna go into a deadlift. So we're gonna keep our legs stiff. You can focus on my feet here for a little bit. As chest goes up, abs are nice and tight, and we're gonna come down. So what I always focus on in my deadlift to make sure I'm keeping my form right, I'm hinging from the hip. So I'm really bending at the waist, but I always look at the joint in the ceiling to the wall, so that makes sure that my chest stays up, which is gonna keep me with a flat back to ensure that I'm not straining my back, but rather I'm working it. So all the weight stays in the heel. Squeeze through the butt and the glutes and the back of, and the hamstrings in the back of your leg as you do that. So come right down, we're gonna kneel back over, and we're gonna go right back into our bent over row. So lean it over, turn your hand back, kind of nice and slow as you bring that in and out with that little bit of an extra pop or squeeze at the end. Relax through the chest or through the neck and your chest stays up. One more, good work. Switch it over. Excellent. So we're gonna go back on our back. We've got scissors again. Put your hands in the small of your back if you need to. Legs are stiff. Heels are pointed towards the ceiling. Nice and slow on these to make sure that we're really feeling it. Peel your shoulders off the floor if you want them to be a little bit harder. Hold those knees in just for a minute, and then we're popping back up, taking our heavy weights, and we're going back into a deadlift. So legs stay stiff, chest stays up, and then push all the way, come down until you feel that nice stretch in the back of your leg, and then kind of push your hips back a little bit. Squeeze through the top. Two more. Excellent work. So, back down. We're gonna do one more set of each. That's chin set too. See how fast this can be? Maximize your time is what it's all about. It's not about doing it at a cost of everything else in your life. It's doing it while being able to still do everything else in your life that's important to you. So let's row it in. And switch it out. Make sure you get that little bit of an extra squeeze. Core is nice and tight. You're really gonna feel this little bit of everywhere. One more, good work. Back on our back. Last set of scissors, lots of core today. Heels are flexed. Pull those knees in. Good stuff. Back up our last set of deadlifts. So let's grab those weights. Focus on really pushing back through the hips as you come down. So you'll almost feel your toes rise up, squeeze through the butt and the back of the legs. We've got two more. Excellent work. Let's grab a sip of water. We're gonna get ready to move on to set number three. Your wrist in a very precarious position. You definitely need to hold on here. Slide your bum off the bench. Now, this is kind of your beginner's one. In the intermediate phase, we're going to start to put our legs out straight. But for our beginners, we're going to keep doing this because we really want to work on building the strength in that tricep so that it's able to do what we want it to do in the future. Give a little squeeze at the top, then come back down. All right. So on this one, we're doing a reverse crunch. So in our reverse crunch is similar to leg raises. You can put your hands under your back again if you need to. We keep our feet together, and we just bring them in and out, focusing on the lower abs. It's gonna feel like a little bit of a small move, but it is working your lower abs better than a lot of our ab exercises will. So you just kind of, it's just a small move. Crunch up so that your core stays engaged the entire time. Let's do two more. Good. All right. So we're moving into pendulum lunge on this one. So what a pendulum lunge looks like is we step back. So right back. Keep the core tight as you come up and tip it over. Try not to put the leg down. We go right back. So we're gonna try on the first set for five and then drop it down. Ideally, not putting that foot back down. You're really gonna feel that in the back of the leg and the glutes, especially after having just done lateral lunges as well as deadlifts. So we're gonna switch it out. We're gonna go on the other side, step it back, keep that core nice and tight, lean it over. Lunge it back. To keep your balance, you're gonna wanna find a spot, stare at it, and keep that core engaged. And last one. And awesome work. So of course we're gonna start that over again. Anytime you need a sip of water, grab it. All right. Hands wrapped around your bench. Knees are at a 90 degree angle. Make sure your body is almost touching, is kind of touching that bench as you come up and down. That's going to put your triceps in the position where they're forced to work. When you start going out like this, it starts taking on more of the front shoulders and not the back of the arms. Three. Good. All right, we're back down on the mat for our reverse crunches. Oh, I don't know about you guys, but I got a nice sweat going on. So let's pull those in and out. All right, let's take it up. This time on our pendulum lunge, we're going for six. So let's keep the chest up nice and high. Core is nice and tight, shoulders are relaxed. Let's take it down, up. Find that spot to stare at to make sure that you can keep your balance. Switch that over to the other leg. Great work so far. All right, let's come back. Lunge it back. Kind of do whatever you want with your hands. I find myself when I keep them up a little bit, helps me balance out. Two more. All right. So we're gonna get ready. We're going to step three, of course. All right, so let's sit on the bench, pull it out. Make sure that at the top you hesitate. Squeeze through the back of the arms as you do this one. Two more. All right, back down for another set of reverse crunch. All right. Alright, should be starting to feel that burden in the core. And on this set, we're gonna make an attempt for eight in our pendulum lunge. Chest is up nice and tall, core is tight, step back, and lunge it forward. I don't know about you, but when I go forward, I can really feel that hamstring screaming at me a little bit. All right, that's eight. Great job. Switch it up to the other side. Step back. Remember, make sure that you're really focused on finding something to stare at. And we've got one more. All right. Good work. Grab some water. We're going to take a little tiny break. We're going to get ready for set number four. All right. So what we're going to be doing on this one is bicep curl. Gotta have good biceps. Kind of welcome to the gun show, you know what I mean? So, we're gonna do bicep curl. So we're gonna change those up a tiny bit today. We're gonna reverse curl. So I'm gonna show you some new ways to do them so that the workouts don't become boring. Then, we're gonna do a sideways scissors, some more abs, especially lower abs, kind of, you know, that whole front panel here that we like to see. And then we're doing a shoulder press, single arm shoulder press. It's gonna seem like four in this one, but it's, you know, it's three sets, one on each side for the other one. So we're gonna get started. You can take up your heavy or your light. Sometimes I like to go with light, you know, in the first set, especially of a new exercise. So remember what we have already learned. As you're doing your standing, knees are loose, core is tight, tip your pelvis in so that you feel like you're in a C. And then what we're gonna do is palms are gonna face back on this one as you bring your arms straight up and down. So your palms stay facing behind you, so you're doing what's called a reverse bicep curl. So you're really gonna hit your biceps in a little bit of a different way. And this can be very awkward, especially if you're trying to lift heavy in the beginning of trying this move. And all right, so we're gonna come down on our mat and we're gonna do sideways scissor. So, I like to put my hands under my back because I have a little bit of a deeper curve and it just feels a little bit more comfortable. Heels are flexed out and we're gonna open and close. Feel that? Immediately you feel that everywhere. Keep that core nice and tight. Make sure we're working what we're supposed to be working. And pull it in, good work. Now, heavy or light on your shoulders, just depends on what you like to do. So we're coming back kneeling. You can put, if you're putting your hand on your leg, you're kind of taking away some of the stability that you're gonna get from, and some of the core work you're gonna get from this. But in the beginning, a lot of the times, it's good to kind of start here. Now, if you feel a little stronger, and you wanna advance it up a little bit, you can put your hand out to the side. So we're gonna keep our arm up, and we're gonna push up and down. You can really feel in this how much more it's bringing the core in. So same thing, 1 to 2 seconds up, and we kind of take it down, 1 to 2 seconds, and switch. 10 on each side again. So let's bring it right up. Keep it going. You're gonna feel that instability, which is great for more core. Everybody loves lots of core. So we really wanna make sure it's strong. You'll notice that I don't overtrain the abs. A lot of people say, well, can we train abs a little bit more? But what we're doing in all of our workouts, our pendulum lunges, our squats, everything, you always hear me talk about keeping your core tight, because the purpose of your core is to make sure it's strong. It's just like every other muscle group though. So until you lose weight, you know, what we want to focus on is strengthening it, because your abs are just like every other muscle. If you grow them too much, you're just going to look thicker around the middle. So the important thing is to grow them underneath, provide the stability that they're created in your body to do for your lower back, your waist, all of that stuff. And what that's going to do for you then is, as the weight comes off and as you get leaner and leaner, then you can start to kind of look at where you want your core to look like. But as long as you're training it, if you overtrain it, you can end up looking thicker. So that's why we don't overtrain and just do, like, 20 minutes abs and things like that. All right, so those reverse crunches, bend the knees, tighten up the abs, and let's reverse them up and down. Let's go for 4, 2, good stuff. Keep that core nice and tight on everything that you do. And, sideways scissors. I almost got ahead of myself there a little bit. Let's flex those heels in and out. Good work. So let's take it up. We're gonna come back into our single arm shoulder press. So again, if you can, keep your arm down by your side as you go through these. You can really feel the abs engaged here, especially in the obliques. All right, switch it up. Other arm. Nice and controlled on this move. And 4. Good work. All right. Our last set, then we're going to stretch. See how great of a workout you can get. Keep that core nice and tight. Up and down. Don't forget to kind of feel like you're creating that C with your body. So the only thing that's moving then is your arms. One more. Good work. All right, we're almost there. Let's come down. Let's do those sideways scissors again. Really feel everything in your core on this one. Two more. right into our shoulder press. Let's bring it up. Feel it? It's awesome. Good stuff. I like to be challenged without feeling like you're killed at the end of a workout. You should feel energized, revitalized, not broken and beaten down. One more. Good work. All right. So we're gonna get ready to stretch. Grab a sip of water. Now, if you do feel like, you know, you've got a little bit more in you, you can always go over to the extras. You can go under the 5-minute fit fix. There are some specialty workouts in there, some high intensity drill, you know, some core body specific, so extra arms, extra abs, you know, cardio, legs, different things. So if you're looking forward to add a little bit to the end of your workout, you feel like you've got a little bit more that you'd like to give, especially, you know, if it's like today while I'm recording this video, it is absolute torrential rains. So while I was already up because I have two dogs, not everybody's gonna get out and get their extra cardio done on days like this. So, you know, doing a little bit extra on those days, or, you know, if you just kind of have a few minutes to spare and you want to get a little bit extra and you feel like you've got that little bit of a push, then go for it. You know, add something from one of those workouts. Or even one of the yoga workouts. It would be a great addition to your program. So let's come up, lean forward. So you get that little bit of a lean back. Feel that deep stretch deep into the psoas and the hip flexor. That feels good. And now what we're gonna do on this one, we're gonna drop that foot off and we're gonna lean over, relax through the quad, and we're gonna really feel that pulling out. So you're gonna feel that deep into the hamstring. You did quite a bit of hamstring work today, even though you might not feel it right now, you will feel it later. All right, let's take it back. And we're gonna switch that out onto the other one with a little bit of a lean back. If you'd like, you can put your arms up a little bit higher or here, whichever is nice. So by pushing in and forward, you're also stretching right down the quad, getting right into the hip flexor and the psoas, and with a little bit of a lean back, you can really push that forward, dig a little bit deeper into it. Most of your stretches you should be holding for about 30 seconds, and then let's shift it back, bring that toe up. So try to think as though you're pulling your chest towards your toe and your toe towards your chest. You're gonna feel that right down into the calf muscle. Keep pushing on that a little bit. Don't push to the point of pain though. Just kind of, you want that nice, good, like, oh yeah, that feels good. But when it starts to really hurt, then kind of ease off of it a little bit. All right, so we're gonna take one foot out because we did quite a bit of inner thigh work as well. We're gonna flatten this foot down, and this one you can see is bent back. So we're gonna lean over a little bit. You're gonna feel this right out through the upper leg, through the tibia, right down into the joints and the connective tissues as your leg turns into your ankle and into your foot. So you're gonna feel a little bit there. You're also gonna feel a nice deep stretch on the inner thigh of that straight leg. And the further down you wanna go, you can go, the deeper you're gonna feel that. And then let's come up and we're gonna switch that over to the other leg. So I always like to kind of ease it by staying up first, get my body used to it, because sometimes depending on what's tight, you can really feel that kind of in the connective tissues everywhere, which is really starts to tell you when you're doing a proper stretch of what's tight on you. So, and then if you can, you can come down. Like for me, instead of it on the other leg, I felt it on the outside, and in this one, I'm feeling it more on the inside of my knee. So that tells me from side to side that I have some imbalances, or, you know, just areas that are a little bit tight in other places. All right, let's come up. You're gonna take it up. Oh, I don't know about you guys, but I got a great sweat on. So let's pull it over, stretch it out through the shoulder, to the back of the shoulder. So you're really using this hand to pull this one back, relax the fingers, release. Let's get into that on the other side. Take it overhead and let's right into this one. So you're gonna feel this nice stretch right up through the rib cage, even up into your armpit, right down around the base, right down through, you know, the hips. And then over to the other side. Oh yeah, I'm gonna look deeper on this one. And let's lean into it as much as you can. Feel that deep, 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 deep stretch. Oh, let's take a nice deep breath up. Thank you so much for coming and making it to week 7. Remember, do this workout 3 times this week. Very excited to start hearing about your results, or, you know, keep you posted on how things are going, how you're liking the workout. Drop me a comment on the video page or in your Facebook, you know, your social media groups. Let us know how you're loving it. Let us know what your results are, what you like, what you dislike, any suggestions, any tips that you have for us. Always feel free to leave us feedback. We love feedback. So congratulations on making it to week 7. That's very exciting. And next week, of course, as promised as usual, we're going to up this again, keeping our workouts in the same format so that you know you have a certain amount of time that you're going to be doing them. If you want to get some extra, jump in on the Yogalicious or any of the TRX workouts, or of course the 5-Minute Fit Fix. Have an awesome day. See you back here next week for week 8.